Global COVID-19 cases are now approaching the 250 million mark. But over the last 3 months, the daily average has fallen by 36% as the surge from the Delta variant eases. Health experts are optimistic that many nations have put the worst of this pandemic behind them, thanks to vaccines and to better treatments. But they caution that the colder weather and the upcoming holiday gatherings may lead to another uptick. Infections are still rising in 55 out of 240 countries, with Russia, Ukraine, and Greece posting record levels or near record levels of new cases. In October, the World Health Organization appealed to the leaders of the world's 20 biggest economies to fund a $23.4 billion plan to bring COVID-19 vaccines, tests, and drugs to poorer nations over the next 12 months. Now, that says more than half of the world's population has yet to receive a single dose. The White House is confident that a mandate requiring workers to be vaccinated or tested weekly for COVID-19 will be upheld at the courts. The Biden administration issued the new vaccine rule last week, which applies to companies with at least 100 employees. Now, that's set to take effect on January 4th. But a U.S. federal court of appeals temporarily blocked that measure, arguing that it raises grave legal issues.
Look, these vaccine requirements have been litigated up and down the courts all over the country. State requirements, for example, one in Maine. And every single court before this one ruled that they were valid. The Supreme Court has turned back several times already various efforts to enjoin other vaccine requirements. I'm quite confident that when this finally gets fully adjudicated, not just a temporary order, the validity of this requirement will be upheld.
After 18 months, the United States is set to lift its pandemic travel ban on international tourists. Starting November 8th, fully vaccinated visitors from 30 countries will be allowed to enter the U.S. They must, however, present proof of vaccination and a recent negative COVID-19 test. Now, the new rule comes as a win for airline companies and travel agencies. Paris-based agency Jet Set Voyages says reservations to the U.S. rebounded from near non-existent to the pre-COVID levels last seen in October of 2019. Elsewhere in the world, Australia will begin administering booster shots as it emerges from a surge of infections driven by the Delta variant. The additional shots will be given to people 18 and over, 6 months after their second shot. Now, the country's federal health minister says some members of the vulnerable population have already been given their third shots ahead of the wider rollout. The states of Victoria and New South Wales dealt with an infection wave during the second and third quarter of the year. Both have, however, emerged from strict lockdowns since.